Investing early in children paves the way for a lifetime of success. To thrive, to soar, Ohio must invest in children when it counts, when their brains are being built, when the foundation for their future is being set.
We're in a competitive world, not only locally, not only in the state of Ohio, but across the country and across the world. We need the best talent in the world to compete.
If we don't start focusing on getting people a credential, a certificate, a college degree, we won't have enough people to work in the jobs of the future.
This year in Ohio, 65% of the jobs are going to require something more than a high school degree.
We know that the healthier we are as children, the more likely we are to grow into healthy adults.
We need our legislators to invest upstream in efforts that prevent the adversities that children are at risk for experiencing.
We need to invest in our children because we know that science tells us if you invest early on, they're better prepared for school, they're better prepared for life, higher graduation rates, lower poverty, lower dropout. It's a clear business case as well as a do right case.
Children growing up in poverty or who experience trauma need early interventions to prevent the impact of adversity from compounding.
There are certain forms of adversity that are more prevalent now than they were 10 or 20 years ago. Behavioral health conditions are significantly on the rise. Substance abuse, you know, especially the opioid epidemic. We see children who grow up in these homes with adversity, their brains are shaped differently.
When you have a 12-year-old, a 10-year-old who is violent, that didn't start when they were 12. That started when they were 2.
Your fight or flight response, your ability to avoid danger, those are the parts of the brain that are going to enhance. At the expense of that, the brain then carves away things like cognition and development. 10 years ago, we didn't know that.
Early intervention starts even before children are born. Ensuring pregnant women get prenatal care is an investment. It saves babies and mothers' lives.
Families can touch hospital systems, but clearly we are worlds away. I walk out my door, turn to the right, and in 0.2 miles is the Cleveland Clinic's front door. And this is the place where babies are not making it to their first birthday?
We rank almost dead last in the nation for healthy outcomes for children reaching their first birthday.
And we pay more per person than most other states do in the country to get those really bad outcomes. If we don't address the factors that are creating these disparities, we're gonna see them continue to worsen. The disparities are unacceptable. The impact on a community's economic stability, I don't even know how to describe it.
Home visiting builds strong families, especially when families don't have support.
I think every parent wants to be a great parent, but some people don't know how to do that. And so building a relationship with the parents, having a nurse come in when the baby is born, and then teaching best practices to parents can make a great difference.
And home visiting really seems to be a way that we can partner with those families to help get them connected to services.
Any extra dollars that we can get into home visiting makes such an impact.
Children in child care deserve high quality learning experiences. Working families need help to afford that care for their children.
Families who have infants and toddlers, the cost of child care, it can exceed the cost of college tuition.
Without government like funding daycare assistance, I wouldn't be able to work.
There are a lot of families that work very hard. Me and my husband go to work every single day. We wake up at 5 a.m. in the morning.
Even if I had a second job maybe, or if I had like a big raise at my current job, we still wouldn't be able to afford it.
If I make, you know, a dollar more, I'm not gonna be eligible for childcare. You go back to school to try to get a better position, and then if you have that better position, you're not eligible.
He comes here before he actually goes to school, because I have to be at work at 5:30 in the morning.
When I hear folks call us babysitters, I invite them to see what we do.
If communities aren't interested in the workforce of the next generation, their communities are going to get smaller and they're not going to have thriving economies. And if we believe that everybody deserves a fair, fresh start, you have to do meaningful 0-to-5 work. We're not giving everybody a fair shot. It's not fair to say by the age of 5 that someone is too far behind.
If the vision is all of Ohio's children, it has to be all of Ohio's children.
There's just a lot of compelling evidence that it's not only the right thing to do, but there's a real return on investment.
Will you support investing in our children so they and Ohio can soar?